begin our life-giving celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning to you all.
Good morning, Father.
At this Mass, we pray for
the repose of the soul of Dorothy and Virgil Smith, Ralph Brown, for Linda Biddle, and Georgia.
We pray for Camila Gonzalez. We pray for Sister Obinna, who celebrates her birthday today. And for all those who have asked for our prayers, that the Lord in His mercy may continue to strengthen and defend us. And we remember to Cecilia at this Mass. My brothers and sisters, we are sinners and in need of God's grace. Let us therefore humbly remember the times we've sinned against God and man. Be sincerely sorry for those times, as we humbly ask God for His pardon and peace.
Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may the Almighty God have mercy on us. May He forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. May Saint Dominic come to the help of your church by his merits and teachings, O Lord. And may he, who was an outstanding preacher of your truth, be a devoted intercessor on our behalf. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Proclamation from the Book of Numbers. Miriam and Aaron spoke against Moses on the pretext of the marriage that he had contracted with the Shuhite woman. They complained, "Is it through Moses alone that the Lord speak? Does he not speak through us also?" And the Lord heard this. Now Moses himself was by far the meekest man on the face of the earth. So at once the Lord said to Moses and Aaron and Miriam, "Come out, you three, to the meeting tent." And the three of them went. Then the Lord came down in a column of cloud, and standing at the entrance of the tent, called Aaron and Miriam. When they both came forward, he said, "Now listen to the words of the Lord." "Should there be a prophet among you, in vision will I reveal myself to him. In dreams will I speak to him. Not so with my servant Moses. Throughout my house he bears my trust. Face to face I speak to him, plainly and not in riddles. The presence of the Lord he beholds. Why then did you not fear to speak against my servant Moses? So angry was the Lord against them that when he departed and the cloud withdrew from the tent, there was Miriam, a snow-white leper. When Aaron turned and saw her a leper, he said to Moses, 'Ah, my Lord, please do not charge us with the sin that we have foolishly committed. Let her not thus be like the stillborn babe that comes forth from its mother's womb with its flesh half consumed.' Then Moses cried to the Lord, 'Please, not this. Pray, heal her.'" Word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm, "Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned."
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Have mercy on me, O God, in your goodness. In the greatness of your compassion, wipe out my offense. Thoroughly wash me from my guilt, and of my sin cleanse me.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
For I acknowledge my offense, and my sin is therefore before me always. Against you only I have sinned, and done what is evil in your sight.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
That you may be justified in your sentence, vindicated when you condemn. Indeed, in guilt was I born, and in sin my mother conceived me.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
A clean heart create for me, O God, and a steadfast spirit within me. Cast me off from your presence, and your Holy Spirit take not from me.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Please stand. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel.
Alleluia.
Get into a boat and precede him to the other side of the sea while he dismissed the crowds. After doing so, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When it was evening, he was there alone. Meanwhile, the boat, already a few miles offshore, was being tossed about by the waves, for the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, he came towards them, walking on the sea. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they said, and they cried out in fear. At once Jesus spoke to them. "Take courage, it is I. Do not be afraid," Peter said to him in reply. "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. But he went in when he saw how strong the wind was. He became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately, Jesus stretched out his hand and caught him, and said to him, "O you of little faith, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat did him homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." After making the crossing, they came to the land of Gennesaret. When the men of that place recognized him, they sent word to all the surrounding country. People brought to him all those who were sick and begged him that they might touch only the tassel of his cloak, and as many as touched it were healed. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning to you all.
Good morning, Father.
I'm battling with two things, you know. This is the Gospel of Sunday. And I think if I delve into it, I might be doing injustice to the deacon who will be on Sunday. But then the first reading reminds us of something that is great. The first reading reminds us about forgiveness. Miriam and Aaron began to speak against Moses, the servant of God. They became very jealous. They became very antagonistic of Moses. Remember, when Moses had gone to receive the Ten Commandments, Aaron with the people built a calf and began to worship it. And when Moses came back, he chastised him, but then he forgave him. Today, the reading tells us, Miriam and Aaron were complaining against Moses. And they began to say to the people, does God only speak through Moses? God doesn't speak only through Moses. God speaks through us too. We are God's prophets. God wasn't happy with that. But he wanted to settle that matter. He summoned them before himself. And they went before the tent of meeting. And God came down. Now when God came down, he brought his justice. God was not partial. And God didn't care how anybody will feel. He said the truth. And he presented it as it were. Encouraging us, my brothers and sisters, that at all times, we need not take sides. At all times, we need to be just. No matter how close we are with anyone, God loved Miriam. He loved Aaron. He loved Moses. But then he has his favorite, as in he has chosen one of them to become the leader among the rest. And that was Moses. So also each and every one of us, at different places and at different points in time, God appoints us to become his spokesperson, or persons, as it were, that we might represent him. And when he appoints us, when he selects us, he grants us the wisdom, the strength. He comes to our aid. He reveals to us what he wants done. So on this day, God summoned the three. And God asked Miriam and Moses, when I speak to any other person, I speak to them in visions. But when I speak to my servant, God was particular. When I speak to my servant Moses, I speak to him one-on-one, face-to-face. He beholds my face, and I behold his face. To whom have I granted that opportunity apart from him? God was not happy, because he knew the rivalry that was growing. And God wanted to put it to an end. Sometimes, my brothers and sisters, we have allowed evil to thrive. We have allowed others to talk about other people and trample down on them. We have known the truth, and we have decided to keep quiet. Sometimes, in some ways, some of us may have even fueled disagreements, discord. But the Lord is telling us, my brothers and sisters, at all times, God chooses one person to represent all. And when God left, the word of God said, Miriam was struck with leprosy. Because of her jealousy and anger, and because of the things she has spoken against Moses. But you see, forgiveness brings us joy and fulfillment. Forgiveness brings us liberation. It does no good when we hold things against people. Yes. People will wrong us. Yes. People will say things about us that even things that are not true, things we do not like, people will offend us. But my brothers and sisters, inasmuch as we become angry, inasmuch as we become upset, inasmuch as hatred begins to grow in our hearts, let us ask ourselves too, do we anger others? Do we wrong other people? What if everyone holds it against us? Who will be our friend? Because even your best friend sometimes suffers punishment on your behalf. Sometimes hears gossips. Sometimes is slander. Sometimes does not face the reality when it has to do with you. Each time and at all times, there is something wrong with us. But God encourages us to forgive. Imagine, Miriam was struck dead before Moses and before Aaron. The same Moses she was talking about. Aaron begged, Moses, please, Do not allow her to remain like this. Heal her. Moses never said a word. He only turned back to God and asked, Lord, may it not be so. Grant her healing. And she was healed. How often do we fail to forgive others? How ready and willing are you to forgive? How ready and willing are you to let it go? How ready and willing are you to allow that fresh air which revives the soul, which revives the body, to come into you? And you exhale that pungent thing in your heart. That you bring out those unwanted feelings and feel good and feel calm. I will tell you this. There is something we say in Nigeria. Somebody who is not happy, always angry. Someone who has refused to forgive others will always look like someone who is fasting. Will always look like someone who is starving and dying of starvation. Give him or her a pot of food. He or she will eat and finish it and still remain like a person. But one who is happy drinks only a cup of water and grows so much nourished and happy that everybody will be wondering, who is feeding this person? God feeds us when we are happy. Allow God to feed you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Bow rise and bring our needs to the Lord.
And Pope Francis and all ministers of the word and sacrament be people of true conversion and speak with prophetic voices. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all leaders of nations be people of true dedication to the good of all humanity, and not only for their local interest. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all citizens accept their duty to respect the natural resources of the earth and prudently manage them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let the members of this community recognize the gift they have received and follow the Holy Spirit and feed the hungry of heart. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who need shelter, food, or support find what they need in our generosity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died will be welcomed to eternal life by the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For your own personal intentions.
For Camila Gonzalez, for Cecilia, and for Sister Robina, who celebrates her birthday today. That the Lord in his mercy may visit his people, bless them, grant them his joy and fulfillment in their lives. And for our prayers in our hearts, Lord Almighty God, bless us, hear our prayers, and grant us what we ask you in faith, because we make these prayers, spoken and unspoken to you, through Christ our Lord.
Standing on the waves and the sea.
pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Amen. Attend mercifully to the prayers we offer you, O Lord, by the intercession of Saint Dominic, and through the great power of this sacrifice, strengthened by the protection of your grace, those who champion the faith through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For in the marvelous confession of your sins, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure sign of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled. Their great example lends us courage, their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks. As in exaltation, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a new fall, and they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Daniel, our Archbishop, Charles, his auxiliary, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and Saints, Saint Paul, Saint Dominic, Saint Peter, Saint James, Saint Ignatius, Saint Anthony, Saint Cecilia, Saint Anne, St. Elizabeth, St. Margaret, St. Agatha, St. Josephine Bakita, St. Anne de Beaupré, and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be good heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
We join our hearts. Let us call God, Father, in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace and joy of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Now let us share silent peace with each other.
Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My brothers and sisters, behold him, Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those of us called to this supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us to eternal life.
Amen.
Thank you. Let us pray. May your church, O Lord, receive with heartfelt reverence the power of this heavenly sacrament, by which we have been nourished on the commemoration of St. Dominic. And may your church, having flourished by means of his preaching, be heard through his intercession, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You have a blessed day.
Amen.